when my loved ones who've gone on before, they are waiting for my boat to land yonder when I step off on that beautiful shore. Someday I'll cross the river, and I'll step off on that beautiful shore. After a while, I'll see Jesus, my Savior, and live in His presence evermore. I've got a lot of loved ones who are waiting for me to cross the road. Yes, I'll be there forever. Step off on that beautiful shore. Someday I'll cross the river, and I'll step off on that beautiful shore. After a while, I'll see Jesus, my Savior, and live in His presence evermore. I've got loved ones, friends, and loved ones waiting. Yes, I'll be forever and forever. I step off on that beautiful shore, and I'll be there forever and forever. I step off on that beautiful shore.
Amen. God have mercy. Amen.
Stood in the courtroom, the judge turned my way. Looks like you're guilty. Now what do you say? I spoke up, Your Honor. I have no defense. But that's when mercy walked in. Mercy walked in and pleaded my case, called to the stand God's saving grace. Blood was presented that covered my sins, forgiven when mercy walked in. I stood there and wondered, how could this be? That someone so guilty had just been set free. Well, my chains were broken. I felt born again the moment mercy walked in. Called to the stand of God's saving grace. The blood was presented that covered my sins, forgiven when mercy walked in. The blood was covered my sins, forgiven when mercy walked in.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you.
upon the mountain. What transfiguration! An angel of the Lord said this could be the day. He said, don't you stand there grieving for the ones that you see are leaving, for like manner is coming back for you and me. And I believe he's coming back like he said. I believe that the trumpet's gonna sound so loud that it's gonna raise the dead. With those eastern skies, and I believe he's coming back like he said. I believe the time is nearing that I'll soon see his appearing. This could be the hour, oh, this could be the day that the saints of every nation shall lose their gravitation in the middle of the air, be called away. And I believe he's coming back like he said. I believe that the trumpet's gonna sound so loud that it's gonna raise the dead. In the twinkling of an eye, he's gonna split those eastern skies, and I believe he's coming back like he said.
Amen. 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 Well, glory to God. I tell you right now that if that don't ring your bell, your clapper's broke. It's good to be in the house of God this morning. Just looking forward. Good time in the Lord. Got a lot of stuff going on today. Baptisms. Just Lord's doing some things at Glen Oak. So appreciative of God just showing us favor. We don't want to lose that. So just remember, keep your eyes, ears, and your open and your mouth shut. Amen. Just keep going for the Lord. Real quick, we got our Bible school meeting. I'm sorry, that Roger did this. Man, what a great associate I got. No, we were together here last Tuesday, and I said Tuesday morning, I guess we was getting stuff for the bathroom. And I said, man, I believe we better call that Bible school meeting off. It's hollering the weather's gonna get bad. You know, but now I heard some people, I don't think we got nothing around here too much, maybe a little rain or something, you know. But I do apologize for that, but we have rescheduled that for this Tuesday night at 6:30. All right, so be here. Amen. If you want to work in Bible school, or if you just, maybe you just got a thought you want to work in Bible school, please show up. We'll need all the help we can get. And please remember our Akron race is April the 20th, and just get with Jennifer. I think they've got that thing. We're getting all up class, man. You can scan all this stuff. But get on there, get with Jennifer. Anybody there can help you. Go to our website. It will give you further instructions on how to be a part of that. Amen? So please get in and get involved. Real quick, now hopefully next Sunday the ladies' bathroom will be up and going. Those guys has really worked diligently on this. But ladies, if you have to go to the bathroom, you're more welcome to use the men's. Just make sure you go in there and you lock the door. Guys, before anybody goes in there, make sure you make sure nobody's in there. We don't want anybody walking in on nobody. Of course, the restrooms are downstairs. You younger guys, just run down there and let's give way to that restroom today for our ladies as much as possible. Our elderly guys, you all go and use that. But you younger ones can go downstairs. But that's looking good. You can peek in there if you want to. They got the floor down, and of course they still got some grout to put on the wall, a little bit of paint to do. And, we still got a little bit to do, but the contractor was telling me that They're going to be starting demoing the downstairs boys tomorrow, I think, and finishing this up by hopefully midweek or so, if I can go up there and get the countertops. But either way, be praying, and be courteous back here, and thanks for your patience. We're going to have a little bit of mess, so don't everybody jump and holler and scream at Rick. It was bad yesterday. There was some dummy walked through the sheetrock and come up on the stage. I don't know who that dummy was. One of them skates dudes. Hey, Lordy, it's good to be in the house of God. I am so glad to be saved this morning. You know, you look around, it seems like it's bad news or opposition, something coming everywhere. But ain't it good to know that no matter what comes our way, we're going to come out victorious. As they were singing that song, when the trumpet of the Lord sounds, I was thinking about all those people that cancer took them to the grave. Well, you know what? Cancer was still in them bodies. But when that trumpet sounds, all that cancer is going to leave. Amen. All that heartache is going to leave. You're going to take on a whole new body. You know, I don't know. I read it one time. I preached on death, and I won't do that. It's a scary message. But I preached on death and what takes place to the body, what death does to the body. You think it's mean to it. You think life's hard. But either way, I had preached that message, and how the hearing and the brain and all of it shuts down, and how it begins to do this stuff, and how that God himself is going to bring life back to that. How that Holy Spirit of God, 6 foot of dirt, a casket, and one of those things, I don't forget what to call it, they put over you. You know, yeah. And, you know, they're up there, so I said, well, when I go 6 foot under, I don't care if the worms eat me or not. But, man, ain't it good to know? Ain't it good to know that when we leave this world, we're going on to glory? If you're here this morning, you can't say that. Boy, I would let this morning be the morning that I'd give my life to Christ. Real quick, let's get this out of the way. Or not real quick. I'm so proud of these folks. Is Kaylee here this morning? Okay, I'll lay it right up here, Brother Rick. Kaylee Cole, of course, she was baptized last week. I want you praying. Now, I want you praying for me too, because I need to get with you. Once a month, as we got so many people getting saved in our church and people coming in, I will start teaching a class maybe once a month or every 6 weeks on new beginners. All right, we're going to do that for a couple times, and we're going to transfer that all downstairs. Matter of fact, we're going to start it downstairs pretty quick. But I do want to give or a chance. There's a lot of people joining the church. Maybe you want to know how I believe, how I feel on things, but you know, we want to go over it, but we're having so many people saved, we got to start discipling these people. All right, we can't just get them saved and leave them. So, all right, Miranda Young, I've seen her, yeah. So proud of you, honey. Yeah, this is, of course, I could give you money, and it'll eventually leave, but I can give you that right there, and that'll take you to eternity. Amen, so proud of you, Miranda. Amen. Joshua Basinger. Of course, Joshua's been down here. He's been up there. But you finally emptied it out to God, didn't you? Amen. Amen. Proud of you. Like I said, I can give you anything I own. It'll all deteriorate, but that right there will take you to eternity. It'll be there. It'll be there. So proud. So proud. Derek West. Come on, Brother Derek. He came down, man. I think night of communion. What a greater night to give your heart to Christ. Derek, I love you, buddy. You take this sword, honey, and you beat the devil to death with it. Amen. Proud of you. Proud of your courage. Amen. Amen. And the last one here will be Keegan Bells. I tell you, old Keegan, old Keegan broke. He broke. You still feeling good before I give you this? Yeah, yeah. Still love that smile. Proud of you, son. Take that thing and use it. That's just a book if you don't use it. Amen. Yeah, it's just a book if you don't use it. It'll bring you great victory. Man, it's good to be here this morning. We do have a baptism. What is it? Oh, you stuck your head up there like I done messed up. Yeah. Anytime I see the sound guys or the video guys look up, you know I'm scared. You city folk get scared. Us country folk, we get scared. Yeah, amen. This morning, really quickly, or not really quickly, I don't preach quick. I do want to take just a second, too, to pray. Won't you pray for Brother Mike McKinney's wife? We were over yesterday in a little men's thing with, with North Hills, and he went home, and his wife had suffered a mini stroke after the service yesterday. So continue praying for him, and I appreciate him so much having us over. I enjoyed it. Man, I eat too much. I preach 2 minutes and burp. Oh, y'all don't burp. Yeah. Mm. Oh, Lord, remember this. I am so sick of hearing these stories. I am so sick of hearing these stories. And, guys, you know, well, brothers and sisters, let's put it that way. God has given us every resource, even His Son. The one thing we got to do, we got to get a little more heavenly minded than earthly minded. Amen? We got to understand that this place is just temporary. That being said, as I was studying for this message this week, I don't study for messages anymore. I really don't. I say, God, what's your word for your children? You know, what's the word today? I can get on the internet and get a message, but I need a word. And I appreciate you making that request, because that goes right along. Today's topic is going to be, your title is going to be on control. Control. You hear of a remote control. You hear of the control panels. About everything walking or everything in existence has some form of control, that if it's got any action to it at all. All right, it's got some kind, something that controls it, or some form of control. And I just looked up today's definition of the word control, which simply means the power to influence or to direct people's behavior. Listen to this now. The power to influence or direct people's behavior or the course of an event. Our nation in the last 4 years has been so mentally, physically, economically, every way you can look at it, so discombobulated. Amen. I look back, and I even look plumb back to the wars. The French, the Revolution, all our wars, all the way up to now. Our country, no matter what, stood united. Now we don't. We have seen that all of these things taking control of our country. Things taking control of our life. Now, I'm not going to get hung up on politics this morning, but I hope we vote Biden out. He ain't getting my vote. And I'll tell him like they told Trump, Biden, you're not my president. If you can't recognize my Savior, I ain't got nary use for you. I got to get off of that. And I told you to shut me up. That still got me fired up. But I want you to know that Satan, there's a warfare in your life, in your individual life. Often we don't like to accept what we're going through, so we begin to look at others. We try to fix their life when our life is all out of control. We worry so much about what's going on in somebody else's life that Satan is tearing our life all to pieces. Somebody get with me now. I'm touching home right now. So today, as we preach this little message, I want you not to worry about your wife, your family, but I want you to say, God, what is in control of my life? Amen? Now, I'm going to say some things, and I may not make sense. If I don't, raise your hand, and I'll try to make better sense. But I want you to know this morning that control is a big word. Because it's got the word influence. It's got the word direction. It's got the word behavior. There's a lot of big words in the definition of the word control. Amen? So are you with me now? Now I'm just going to read what I wrote down as the Holy Spirit gave to me. You have to gain control in order to lose control. Now that's where I was afraid I'd lose you. You have to gain control in order to give control over to God. If you're out of control, you're expecting God. Well, it's time that you quit being lazy. There's things that we take on in the flesh that we give the flesh so much of it, it's called, the proper word is called addicted. When we say the word addicted, we automatically want to go to drugs, alcohol, and stuff like that. But there's an addiction to gossip. Amen? There's addiction to pride. There's, back when I was fishing a lot and before I got in church, fishermen are liars because they're full of pride. Hunters are liars until you see the deer they really shot. Its feet's bigger than its horns. But what I'm trying to tell you, we often, when we hear these words, control, addiction, stuff, we automatically want to go to the worst of the worst. But believe it or not, children, we everyone battle these things in our lives. Amen. Now, get your mind off the drugs and alcohol and all that. I'm talking about the addictions of your behavioral issues, the influence in your life. And there's things that you go through that you've got to get control of if you want God to make or take control of your life. Amen. And you'll hear this again. God really don't want to take control of your life. He wants you to give Him control of your life. Does that make sense? He don't want to have nobody. I don't like for anybody to come up and if you come, I would much rather give you my money than you to take my money. Amen. So God wants you to give Him. He wants your weaknesses. He wants your failures. He loves that because He's made strong in that. He wants you to admit, God, I can't do this. So you've got to control the way you take control of it. As you say, you recognize, first of all, that you cannot handle it. It is overpowering you. So now you've got some control to give God control. Somebody get with me this morning because God wants to control some lives this morning. There's some of you, you're coming in here, you're doing everything, you'll go out and you're living the same old life that you lived when you come in here because you lose control as soon as you walk through those doors right there going back out. Amen. I was sitting there yesterday. I've yet to have my boat in the water, but I thought, man, I'm going to spray her down with hot sauce and get her ready. Hot sauce buffs her up real good, you know. So I'm sitting there just polishing the boat, ain't never been in the water. Oh, Mike calls me and he said, preacher, pray for my wife. I said, brother, I'll be doing it. I'll pray for her. And I hung up the phone and I went back to doing my thing, cleaning my boat. And God said, I thought she's going to pray for her. So pray for her right now. So I started going, he said, don't pray. So I thought, man, Sheila's going to thought I have lost my mind when she sees me on the ring. So I began to pray and I started praying out loud. God, take control. Let me lose control so you can take control. Amen. You can't lose control if you don't have control. Are you with me? Guys, we're in the most trying time that the church has ever faced. Charlotte, I love you. This is my mom now. Charlotte took over Mama's place when Mama went to heaven. I'm just going to pick on you just for a minute. This is not mean. But you've been in the ministry a long time singing, hadn't you? Did you ever think 45 years ago that you would be faced, the church would be faced, or the world would be faced with some of the things that they're faced with today? You would have never thought that, would you? All you elderly folk would have never thought that. Now, what you got to understand, we were living in that time. These kids, it's natural. It's natural for Satan to want to take control of their mind before the truth ever hits it. Now, I'm going somewhere with this, and we'll get on out of here. So I want you to know today that God can't take control till you gain control and hand it over to Him. You got to give it to God. I need God more, Sister Faye, than when I'm just on my deathbed. I got to have Him every hour, every day, every moment. Then Brother Kevin, I hung up the phone. And a little boy I grew up with, Rex Ferguson, made some bad decisions in his life. at an early age, ended up spending 32 years in the penitentiary. My phone rang. I said, who the world? I kind of started getting aggravated, Brother Roger. I said, who the world? I can't even get my boat. Hello? He said, hey, Danny. I said, hey. He said, you know who this is? I said, no, not really. I don't recognize the voice. He said, this is Rex. He said, I didn't want to call you until I got out of the penitentiary. He had surrendered his heart to Jesus, wanting to let me know. Man, I said, and this was confirming my message. Rex, you finally took control and let God have control. Amen. I hope I don't lose you with this. But we have to gain control in order to lose control. In order for God to take complete control of your life, you have to take control of what's causing you the issues. You have to recognize the issues in order to gain control. Remember, from pornography to lying to cheating to all of that. Addictions there. That is an addiction. But when the flesh becomes common to that, then it loses control to it. That is what's controlling your life. That is what's influencing you. That's what's giving you your direction. That's what's giving you your behavior. That is the course you have put yourself on. Y'all ain't with me this morning, are you? See, I want God. Everybody got remote control. I fuss more at my house because I lose remote control. Them kids get up there and they go down under the couch, and there I go to digging, and I can't hardly get out of the floor anymore. But that remote control can control everything on my TV. The volume, turn it off and on, change channels. I delete all the stupid stuff off from it. And as I was looking, I said, God, please take my remote control and push what button you need me to do. When I need to shut up, mute me. When I need to talk, turn me up. When I need to flip channels, flip my channel, Lord. When I need just to sit back and let you be God, then turn me off. Amen. Take control of my life. Pay close attention to what is controlling you. Some of our biggest control issues is letting God have his way in our life. It is not necessarily us seeing it as being bad. See, there's a lot of things that we like I said, we want to stereotype. The alcohol, the drug abuse, this, that. But how many, and I hope I don't offend nobody this morning, but we got to get real. Some of you all that's ever played ball, we would practice all week, especially in football. And they'd grab your helmet and they'd about shake your head off. And he said, now you've practiced all week, but it's about to get real. Amen? It's about to get real, children. So sometimes it's the things that we bargain that's okay to put God on the back burner with. Amen? Some of our habits, our hobbies, sometimes it's our family that control our life. It's the pleasures of our flesh that control our life. It's what we see Hollywood doing. Let me fill you a little secret. Ain't it funny when Hollywood starts doing their bodies that way, everybody else follows? And then the sports people. Amen? And we follow, and we say God has nothing wrong with it, and they're so double-minded. Ain't it funny how you got 90% of them Yahoo idiots out there in Hollywood? We got to get rid of them guns. But we're going to make a movie and we're going to blow each other's head off with them. Yeah. We got these guys that get up and I'm not going to mention names here because I'll get in trouble and I'll probably get thrown out of the state of Tennessee. We love Jesus. I love Jesus. I'm not making light, boys. I'm just telling you this morning. I'm talking about things that's controlling America, and it'll control you. And that control, with God not being in control, you're out of control, and your life is going to stay miserable. Oh, I just want to thank the Lord. Now, I'm not saying all these guys are that way. How many superstar footballs have you seen quit their job and go to church on Sunday morning? About to preach right now. So we, those race car drivers. Oh, Danny's meddling this morning, but that's all right. What I'm trying to tell you, what these children, they don't know any better. When I went to play ball, and we played as much ball as anybody, the first thing they told us, we do not play on Sundays, we do not play on Wednesdays, and if you're looking for that, you'll have to find another league. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I know I love sports too, I'm not picking on it. Fishing's another one. Well, I made it to the Classic. I got to fish Sunday. I got to fish Sunday. I got to practice. This is time we fish. I got to practice. Let me tell you something. If you're not getting close to something, you're getting further away from it. But these guys will tell you how much they love Jesus, and something will go on, or they'll mic them up, or they'll put a thing in their helmet, and all you hear is MFS, MF that, MFS, GD that. You don't sound too godly. I'm fixing to shut up. What I'm trying to tell you this morning, these simple things that you don't realize is controlling your life, and you got to take control of them, or you're going to keep dealing with the same issues you've always dealt with. You take control of that. Say, you're not going to be able to handle it. I tell you, I've never met an alcoholic, Brother Roger, that didn't need help, that didn't need help. They had to have help. And they would recognize what the first thing at AA meetings, they have them to recognize their problem. I am an alcoholic. Now we can do something with you because you recognize what's going on in your life. And you've took control. Now let us take control and help you. Same thing with Jesus. I am a sinner. I can't cleanse my sins, but I'm handing them over to you so you can do what I can't do. Amen. Will that preach? Okay. What is controlling you? Is it your job, money, relationships? Young people, listen to me. Some of you older people, don't get in a relationship with an unbeliever. If you take a liking to them, the first thing you need to ask them, do you go to church? Are you saved? If you give your heart to Jesus? If they're drinking and all that, you will not change them. They will change you 90% of the time. You'll be backslidden. Amen. Relationships. Maybe your job, your money, your relationships. Listen to everybody else's advice for your life. Is that controlling you? Huh? They, some of you, you'll go to every, when you, if you go to 10 different people about what's going on in your life, they're going to give you 10 different statements on how to fix your life. You're the one that needs to take control, and you need to take it to the Word of God and let God fix it. Amen. Now, I'm not telling you that there's people out there that don't have mental illness that need help. And I encourage you to seek help. If I break my doggone leg, I'm going to go to one of them wellers, what do they call it, KOC. Fix my leg. It's broke. God, give these doctors knowledge. Don't be silly. Or the biggest one that might be controlling your life is fear. Amen. Fear. Fear. You can take control of people easier with fear than you can money. I remember a very successful man, businessman, made a bunch of money. He took sick. He told a friend of mine, he said, I have spent all my health making my wealth. Now I'm spending all of my wealth to maintain my health. Fear. I'm probably going to get in trouble for this. I don't know. I'm not one of them people, what you call that, where they bring up all these theories and stuff, conspiracies. I'm not into that. But ain't it funny? Ain't it funny? How that when the buildings collapsed. Everybody run to the church. They is out of control. Their minds were running crazy. Fear had overtaken them. And they knew the only relief they could get was God. They were scared that we were going to war and it was going to break out on this very land that we call the land of the free. And they were scared and the churches were overflowing for about 6 months. But fear controlled them. Then we see in 2020, there's a little thing that we can't even see with the eye called COVID. That come in, they shut the schools, they shut the churches, they shut the jobs. They got you dependent on the stimulus money. They got you thinking you had it. Can I tell you, honey, the day's coming. America has sold out. They've lost control. It's up to the church. The China people own most of our farmland. They're buying up our poultry places. You might have a $300,000 pocketbook, honey, but you won't even be able to buy a piece of bread to put in your empty belly. The Bible says that they'll cast their gold and their silver, the merchants, into the street, and there'll be nothing worth it. You might have a fine house and a new car, but put salt on it and eat it. Control, fear controls. Amen. Fear will control you. It'll make you spend every dime you got. It'll make you do things that you thought you'd never do. I'm not a conspiracist. But you shut down a whole nation so you can manipulate the minds. Do you realize that I didn't see kids acting like cats? I seen the thing, and you can get mad at me. We spent, I don't forget what one of them countries it was. We give them, in 2021 I may be wrong on the number, but it was way up there, like $7 million for gender identity. Huh? Well, heck fire, I could save them some money. Or how many people's in that country? They can't be no more than 1.5 million. Well, go to the Dollar Tree and buy some of them 50-cent mirrors and tell them to go into the bathroom and drop their drawers and look down there, and whatever you got, that's what you is. I'd just save you some money right there. But through this little virus that we couldn't even see, they took control of our lives. Now, was it real? Absolutely. Was it man-made? Probably. Because, see, a lot of people get mad at me for who I support. I'm not asking any politician to come and lead my Sunday school class. I'm not asking any See, when I look at the politicians, and when you hear me preach politics, you're looking at a man. You're looking at a title on the man. I'm looking at the policies of what this man says he stands for. And if he stands for the B-I-B-L-E, then that is the man for me. I don't care what he does outside of there, as long as he does what he told me he's going to do. Hey, I'll eat bread from Satan just as well as I will from the supermarket, honey. You remember the little story, and I got to close. I got to shut up. I ain't even read the scripture yet. Started preaching. You remember the little story of the woman that had the man, the son, and he was meaner than a rattlesnake. And they become out of food. And he said, now what you going to do now, Mama? Call on God? She said, absolutely. 3 days she prayed, just very little. They ran completely out of food. She ran completely out of food. And she prayed out. She said, God, I'm hungry. I need food. And he said, I'm going to show my mama how stupid this thing, this God thing is. And he went to the supermarket. And he bought a bag full of food. And he laid it on her doorstep. He rung the bell and he stooped around the house and was peeking around to watch his mama. She come out. She began straight. Instead of grabbing for the food, she just lifted up and said, oh, Jesus, thank you. You are my Jehovah Jireh. And she began to praise and do a little Holy Ghost dance there. And she picked it up and she said, just one more thing, Jesus. I want to praise you for supplying me with this food. But I want to praise you more for making Satan do it. See, the wealth of the wicked is laid up for the righteous. That's scripture. I'm not talking about you dead presidents. I want you real quick to turn to, I didn't give you the scripture, did I? It's going to be 1 Corinthians 10:13. Then we're going to close in Psalms 46. David, honestly, if you'll give me about 5 minutes, honey, and come on down, we'll be done. I want you to look at this. You say, Brother Danny, I've tried. I'm not finding. It just, Brother Robbie, me and you ain't the smartest men in the building, are we? Well, we're not the prettiest in either. But we ain't the dumbest one, are we? If you take your finger and you stick it in a fire, what's going to happen to your finger? All right? Tomorrow, if you take your finger and stick it in a fire, what's going to happen? It's going to say nothing. So if you continually stick your finger in the fire, what's going to continually happen? You're going to continually get burned, ain't you? Boy, it don't take Einstein to figure out, does it? So there's a point you recognize what is causing you the trouble, and you stay away from it. You take control of it. I'm not going over no more. I've burnt my finger off. I got to quit talking country. Did I say finger? My finger. I'm going to get modernized one of these days. But I want you to see that God knows what every man goes through. Do you know what you realize we all battle the same situations? We're going to see this scripture right here and we're fixing to close. Verse 13 is 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13 says, there hath no temptation taken you but such as common to man. As is common to man. But, I love the conjunction but. Because see, that means something about to turn around. God's fixing to take my bad and conjoin it to his good, and he's fixing to make good in my life. Watch God take my bad, the things that I can't handle, that's common to me, that I can't take care of, and I can't take control of. God's going to take and he's going to put that conjunction in there, and he's going to lock them together, and he's going to take the evil out, he's going to take the mean out, and he's going to replace it with good. Now watch what the word says. There hath no temptation taken you but such as is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that you are able, but will with the temptation also make an escape, a way to escape that you may be able to bear it. Somebody listen to me now. I know it's you're ready for some fried chicken. In other words, there is no temptation. Stupidest thing I ever seen. I got to hurry. I'm telling all kinds of stories this morning. Some of y'all don't know this, but you remember them big old cars? Today they don't happen as much, but they had cigarette lighters in them. And I don't remember what kind of car it is. I just know it was about 2.5 blocks long that my buddy's daddy owned. Might have been a station wagon. But in the door, you remember they was cigarette things everywhere, ashtrays. Well, there was a cigarette lighter in there, and you pushed that thing down, and you remember it would, pop, when it was ready, it'd pop back up. Well, if you yanked that thing right out there, it'd be going red. Well, my buddy, we was just sitting in the car. There's about 4 or 5 of us sitting in that big old car. We wasn't very old. He popped that, boop! It pops out and it's just blood red. Well, if you ever looked at them, see, when you didn't have a lot of money, you found entertainment, a lot of stupid stuff. He looked at it, and it quit glowing, and it turned off white. Well, he goes, just because it ain't going don't mean it ain't still hot. Now, I'm telling you the truth, and I remember, I'll never forget it, Archie, for a long time. And I'll tell you who it was, Sister Jenny Lou. She's hurt her back. She's out today. It was her brother. And he had them little, you know, had them little rings. And he had them little rings on his finger forever. Just because it don't look harm or look like it hurt you, it can still hurt you. So God said, I will make an escape for that, through that temptation. Now, I guess it was just tempting to see if that was hot. He learned from his first mistake. So God give him a mistake or an escape. It's called common sense. Remember, the greatest rule of interpretation I'll ever be able to give you, if plain sense makes sense, let it be the sense or else it'll all come nonsense. If plain sense makes sense, let it be the sense or else it will all become nonsense. It don't make plain sense to stick your finger in something that's going to burn it. Once you've done it once, you ought to know better. In closing, I want you to turn over real quick to Psalms chapter 46. It's a short verse, short chapter. We're going to read this. We're going to get out of here. God is our refuge and strength. Now, I want you to watch what we're saying this morning. You've got to gain control in order to give God control. If you don't remember nothing else I say this morning, if you're going through some issues in life, and don't worry about what everybody else is doing. It ain't none of their business, ain't none of your business. Right now, God's talking to you. He's talking to you. If you're out of control, gain control and hand God control. You're not going to be able to, when I say gain control, I'm not talking about you're going to be able to fix the situation within yourself. Recognize what you got you out of control and hand that over to God. Then let God control it. God is our refuge and our strength and a very present and very, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore will I not, I can't see this for nothing. Therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. There is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God. Now watch this. The holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. In the midst of her. He's in the midst of his church. Remember, it's common. Everything you're going through is common to man. In other words, we all face this. We all face these issues. That's common to man. Let me tell you something. God never said he'd take them away. He said he'd give you a way to sustain them and control them through him. So we see the heathen raged. Watch this. That thing that's controlling you. The heathen raged, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice and the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge, Selah. Come, behold the works of the Lord. What desolations he hath made in the earth. He maketh wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow. He cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in a fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The Lord, the God of Jacob is our refuge, Selah. In closing, as we stand today, what he's saying, little children, don't worry about it. Hand me your issues because I'm going to take the very thing that Satan, the very weapons that Satan's got, and I'm going to break them and I'm going to burn them, and you will stay safe because I am your refuge. Give him control this morning as they sing. For all that's going to be baptized really quickly before they start, come right here in this corner. And I'm going to turn this up. For everyone that's going to be baptized, just meet right here in front of Kevin before they begin to sing. For any family members, you're welcome to come up here. Sheila, you don't mind, will you go up there with me? Come on in. Yeah, come right over here, sweetheart. I'm so proud of you all, man. Man, what a great, great, great thing God has done in this family here. Yeah, go right there. Children, I'm fixing to go baptize these that surrendered their life to Christ. They allowed God to take control. There's some of you in here, man, you've been saved for years. You've been saved for years. But you've never grown one bit in God. Your breath smells like spoiled milk. God's got a nice filet mignon he's wanting you to take a bite of. Amen. Not necessarily substance that's controlling you. It may be just people. I don't know. This morning, take control of that and say, God, I recognize what's controlling me. Now you take control of my life. I'm giving it to you. I'm going to turn this over to Brother Roger. If you would, please open the doors of the church this morning as well for membership. Amen. Amen.
I know that I'm not worthy to call upon your name. All my life I've been a sinner, and for that I am ashamed. But I heard that you would listen, so I'm giving you my plea. I'm too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me? I know that there are others who could offer more than I promise you I'd understand if for me you have no time. I think I just hit bottom, and I'm looking up to see. I'm too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me? I guess I must be reaping from the seeds that I have sown. Well, Lord, you owe me nothing. We haven't spoken for so long. But if you could spare some mercy, I pledge my life to thee. I'm too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me? I know that there are others who can offer more than I promise you I'd understand if for me you have no time. I think I just hit bottom, and I'm looking up to see. I'm too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me? I think I just hit bottom, and I'm looking up to see. I'm too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me?
Let's sing that last verse one more time, Brother David and team. Your life may be out of control, as the preacher just preached to you here this morning. You may have chaos in your life that nobody knows about, but you're just tore up inside. And the only way to get out of that chaos is to let God get control of your life. And maybe you've been asking for change in your life, but you've never taken a step to do that. Why don't you just step out here this morning and say, I'm ready for change. I'm ready to take control of this thing of my life that is so disrupted, and let you, God, be in control. You know, our Underwood sung that song, Let Jesus Take the Wheel. There's nothing wrong with that. Let him take control of your life, and you'll see change in your life. As they sing this last verse, won't you please come here this morning? It's time that you just gave up and submitted your humbleness to the Lord. and let him have a part of your life. Maybe you've never done that. Maybe you've just been living your life from day to day in chaos, and you just say, I just need that help. And God, when you get humble, God will show you he can help you in that time of need. He just read the book of Psalms. Your refuge in a time of help is there. Won't you step out this morning? Let your pride wall down. Let the friend beside of you, don't worry about what they'll think about it, but just come up to this altar here and have a minute with the Lord. We'll be glad to pray with you and let you know how much God can change things. Amen. As they sing.
I guess I must be reaping from the seeds that I have sown. Lord, you owe me nothing. We haven't spoken for so long. But if you could spare some mercy, I pledge my life to thee. I'm too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me? I know that there are others who could offer more than I. I promise you I'd understand if for me you had no time. I think I've just hit bottom, and I'm looking up to see. I'm too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me? I think I've just hit bottom, and I'm looking up to see. I'm too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me?
Gonna reach heaven, sure, oh please, just let me kneel once more. I've got so much to thank Him for. Yes, I've got
so much to thank Him for, so much to praise Him for. You see, He has been so good to me.
And when I think
of all He's done and where that He has brought me from, I've got so much to thank Him for.
Do you want me to tell him or do you want to say it? Do you want to tell him what happened to you?
I got saved.
This morning, we're definitely baptizing in Chili Jordan. Water, go! I don't know what you adjusted, but adjust it back. Hey, why they do? I'll let Roger do the baptism. He gets them. It's too hot.
It's hot.
Boy, they made up for it. Yeah. Amen. What we're going to do, Mr. Paxton. It's go. Yeah, you'll get used to it. Don't. I don't think you're going to need this. Amen. I don't blame him for shouting because I about did a little myself.
That's where I'm at.
I got to say this. We joined over at Loveland, and I never understood this. Oh, yeah, just a minute. give it about 10 minutes, you'll get used to it. We was over at Loveland, and I was a janitor. And we had about 7 to be baptized, me and Sheila and Brandon. Was it you, Tiffany? It was you. Was involved. And, man, I forgot to turn the heater on. Oliver went down in there, and he said, I'm killing you. Amen. All right, let these people know what happened to you. You get saved?
Yeah.
Give your heart to Jesus?
Yeah.
When you die, where are you going?
To heaven.
To heaven. Amen. What a great honor it is for me to baptize you this morning, my brother. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, we go to the grave with Christ, and we come up in the newness of life. Amen. 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 Liam, this is a little cold, baby. Yeah, it's like getting in the swimming pool, but it's a lot hotter outside when you get in the swimming pool. It's not that cold, though, because you're tougher than the preachers. All right, look right here. Turn around this way. Your face dies. This is Liam. He come up on the stage. I'm so proud of him. Tell him what happened to you. Did you get saved? Yes, I got saved. You know, I've often had people say, well, they don't understand. When a kid or anybody tells me what the consequences of their sin is, it could be if they die and going to hell, which this young man did, he realized what would happen to him if he died in his sin. It was ready for him to be saved. Amen. All right, you turn around like this. All right. Is everybody, you got him? Okay. All right, put, hold your nose. Father, we come to you. What a great, great joy, Lord. What an honor it is to baptize my brother Liam in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Into the grave with Christ we go, and up to you we come with him. Amen. 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 this in a while. I was a lot younger and stronger. But we're going to do this. Here, let me have your hand, Brother Wade. Nice water's coming, honey. I'm sorry. It's kind of what it feels like to fall in the lake. Sorry, yeah, it's usually warm. All right, yeah, you all come right here. Stand right in front of me. You're right here. I got you. Yeah. It's been a while since I baptized, too, at the same time. So we're going to do it because they want to be done. Now, if we're down for a minute, we'll come back up. I promise. I might get back up. Come on, bring it. There you go. Jen's nose. Let the church, first of all, know what happened to you. Jen's give you a heart to Christ, been saved. You die, you're going to heaven. Amen. Of course, we know Brother Whaley got saved at the hospital. And of course, Hannah gave her heart to right here to Christ last week. And what a great, great, great opportunity it is and a privilege it is me for to baptize them. So this morning, I just love the Lord for what he's doing in our church.
Amen.
Kids getting saved. Get them ready to baptize. I promise you we'll get the heat working. But guys, I can't reiterate enough how important it is in this day and time that we teach these children about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now I'm going to hang on you, Brother Raymond. I've got your back. Okay, so y'all come down with me. We'll come up together, all right? Father, we come to you. What a great honor it is to baptize this grandfather and granddaughter at the same time, Lord. God, as they go down into this watery grave and come up in the newness of your life, Christ, we baptize them in the name of Jesus. We need to baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Holy Ghost. How much you missed?
The whole top of his head. I dug him again.
We
I screwed him down with water hose.
Yeah. Alan said I missed the top part of his head. It'll be fine. It'll be fine. Usually when you do two of them, you're in the river. But man, what an honor it was for a grandfather and granddaughter at the same time giving their heart to Christ. What a great family God has brought into our church. I love every one of you. I love every one of you. My heart's prayer for you is when you leave this building this morning that you let God take control of your life. Amen. Brother Roger, I'm going to turn it over to you, and I'm going to go put on some dry clothes and find me a heater.
Are you coming out to eat?
Brother Rick, there is warm. It was hot last week. Those of you who got baptized last week, you know what hot is. Yeah. Brother Don, you and Jeanette, if you would come up. We're going to open the doors of the church here. Brother Don's been coming with us quite a while, and is who? I think they're trying to get warm. But Brother Don and Jeanette, I know Jeanette's had a lot of physical problems and couldn't be with us every week, but we're so glad to have this family. Someone make a motion? Second? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Amen. If you'd stand, please. Brother David, if you'd play something, if you would come around and shake, give them a hand of fellowship. And we're so glad to have them. Is there anyone else before we close? If not, let us pray here and we'll dismiss. Father, Lord, I thank you, Lord, for this day that you've given us, Lord. What a rejoicing, Lord. A soul saved, Lord, and many that gave through baptism, O Lord. We just thank you, Lord, for the day, Lord, that you've given us that, Lord, to have that time of worship, Lord. The songs of Zion, Lord, just to feel your spirit here this morning, Lord. What a rejoicing that is, Lord, just to know that you're ever present with us, O Lord. Bless this family, Lord. Bless all of those, Lord, that are facing the control issues out there, Lord, that just didn't step out today, Lord, to turn them over to you. And, Lord, we give you praise, honor, and glory. Amen.
Give me your hand.